Hello there, Marshall here from Limited Resources, doing another draft with you here on Channel Fireball. We've got some Eldritch Moon action here, and we opened a really good card, Voldarn Pariah. Some other good stuff too, the Ulvenwald Captive, the Wretched Griff. Not a big fan of Blood Mist, but you can build around it, and so if you do want to take it pretty early, this is a little early, but if you want to take it early in a pack, you can certainly build an effective deck around it where you kind of maximize on it. Those are the only decks I actually like Blood Mist in at all. Basically any of the regular red deck, I don't like it. But anyway, whatever. We're taking the Voldarn Pariah. That is, to me, the best card in the pack by pretty easy margin there. So I like a Dragunder or an Olivia's Dragoon here. I'm actually just going to take the Dragunder. I really think Dragunder's great. And here's another one. Yeah, I'll just take it. Tangleclaw Werewolf's pretty good too, but I'm happy to just move in here a bit. Okay, here we can take a Wretched Griff or a Certain Death. I'll take the Griff, I guess. I like the Wretched Griff a lot. It's a little expensive. Like we've got a 5, a 7, and a couple of 3s here, but you know, the cards that you need to make Wretched Griff good are often the same cards for Voldarn Pariah. You know, your Enlightened Maniacs are kind of high on that list. Same thing with Exultant Cultist. Those are the type of cards that you want to see. Plus, I kind of like taking blue here. I mean, there's always the off chance that we don't end up playing the Voldarn Pariah, in which case, you know, you kind of want to concentrate your colors on the other end of the spectrum. You don't want to get married to your first pick. That is a lesson that is very difficult to learn for a lot of people. And it's understandable. It's very tempting. You got a card this strong, you want to stick with it. And look, you should try. You should. Like, you should lean in that direction. These are the type of cards that can win you the game. But you just don't want to, you know, the next 6 cards, there's not even a decent black card, which, by the way, there already were, so we're probably fine. But if there weren't, you know, get off it. But you can put this over here. Drafts are long. You get a lot of picks. You're getting, what, like 42 picks or whatever it is total? Any one pick out of that, you should be able to ditch, even if it's your first one. All right, what do we have here? No good blue cards. Effectively no good black cards. I'm not really a big fan of Oath of Liliana. Sometimes I bring it in out of the sideboard, but even then it's not great. So I think we're going to take one of these green cards here. Maybe just a Bloodbriar. Maybe a Kessig Prowler. I like that card too. Yeah, we'll take that guy. Fogwalker, Laboratory Brute. And it looks like the black actually is starting to dry up on us a little here. I'll take this Lab Brute. Okay, here is a Spontaneous Mutation. I like that. So we're getting relatively settled into blue here. I like a lot of the cards we've got in blue, but we do need to figure out our second color, and so far that just hasn't really popped up. I'm going to take Borrowed Grace here. It's just the best card in the pack, and there's really nothing for us. Blood Mist did come back. I could also just take a Skursdag Supplicant. I think we're probably more likely to play that than any of the other cards. If we do end up in black and we're a little short on playables, we'll play it. Here's a Cemetery Recruitment. It's probably enough to play these colors, but I guess you never quite know. Okay, what do we got? Okay, we got some stuff. There's a Scour Laboratory and a Boon of Emrakul. I'm going to take this Boon. I really like Scour a lot, but like, I think Boon is probably just a better card. And I think it's one of the better cards in the pack, so we'll take it. Oh boy. Bruna, huh? Otherwise, we're taking Nabelgast Herald. God dang. All right, fine. Okay, so this one we could take the Dusk Feaster, which maybe we want to do. Otherwise, we're taking an Olivia's Dragoon, which also is fine. It might be better. I'll probably just take it here. Yeah. I want to make sure that I get enough cheap cards. And a Dusk Feaster certainly is not that. Nice. An Abundant Maw. I like that. We need some more cheap creatures. Cheap and middle ground creatures for sure. We're lacking pretty sorely there. But we've got a lot of pack here in pack two and then all of pack three as well. So it'll be all right. Okay, no good black cards. There's one Blood Hall Priest. The only other card is Choking Restraint. I'm going to take the Blood Hall Priest just on the off chance that we end up splashing it. There's just nothing else in the pack anyway. Walking Wailing Ghoul, I mean. Is it better than Fogwalker? Let's see. Are we actually trying to get stuff in the graveyard here? A little bit for the Spontaneous Mutation and the Cemetery Recruitment. But this actually does affect the board. Yeah, I guess we'll go for the Wailing Ghoul. Wow, I guess we're in the wrong colors. Look at this. Whatever, I'll just help somebody out at our table, I guess. Okay, another Spontaneous Mutation that was really good. That's lucky. Honestly, I'm kind of surprised that's here based on what we've seen from the packs. It just feels like we're kind of zigging when the table is zagging. Though, you know, now that I see this, maybe it's just... maybe it's just a little bit of misfortune here about what cards have been opened, because there's a couple of decent cards here. I don't know. Probably still the case. I like Graph Harvest as a sideboard card against really grindy matchups. And I do like drawing cards, so I'll probably end up playing that. Convolute is not impossible that it makes the cut. Okay, well, this thing is starting to come around, but we really do need to round out a lot of stuff here. Flameblade, Breakneck, Farbog, Fiery Temper? God, and then a bunch of junk. Oh, that's bad. I really don't want Olivia's Bloodsworn for this deck. I either want the stupid Skeleton or the Silent Observer. Ugh, maybe the Farbog, but I think I'd rather have one of these two. God, that's bad. Do we have any, like, actual discard outlets right now? We can get it back with Laboratory Brute just for value. Also, Sanitarium Skeleton discard, or Sack into Pariah is fine. God, this is embarrassing. All right, well, this pack's a lot better. Hold the Beyond's probably decent, but I'd rather just have a Tooth Collector, I think. I just think this card's really good. It just so often just kills a creature these days, just when it enters a battlefield. Take a dead weight out of this pack. Card's great. Liliana's Indignation, no. No, that's not the one. That is not it. Nibbless of Dusk or a Stallion. Take a Nibbler. All right, I want another 2-drop and I want another removal spell, and then I'm good. That's all I ask. All right, Stitch Mangler will do. I like that better than Daring Sleuth. I do also think that Jace of Scrutiny is quite good, but I'm going to take the Mangler here. We can probably cut something out of here. Oh, Aberrant Researcher? Yes, please. Is that better than Stitchwing Scob? I think so. We've got quite a few things that can flip it, right? Ooh, not that much, actually. Recruitment, a couple of Dragon Lure, maybe a Convolute. Oh, we don't actually have that much that can flip it at all. Well, no. Maybe I spoke too soon. They're succumbed to temptation too, but yeah, still not a lot. Crow or Silent Observer? You know, I still think I'd rather just have Crow. Like, does it feel better if I put it there? Probably. Kill this Bloodhall priest. What? Why is this here? I mean, I don't even take it because it doesn't matter anymore, but like, I have absolutely no clue what that's even doing. God, weird. I think I'm going to kill the skeleton. I don't really love it here. It's not great with the merge. It's only cost one. It's fine to sack to the pariah. That part I do like about it, but the rest of it is so mediocre. I don't know. Maybe I could play it over the Wailing Ghoul since they're both so bad. I could also just play it over a Convolute, but I kind of don't hate a Convolute in a deck like this. I wonder if I should play this Cultist Staff. That's kind of the big thing that I'm wondering. I think I don't need it, though. I'm not going to play it. 9-8, huh? I think it's actually better this way. Yeah, I think that's better.